हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू। टॉपिक इज़ दैट शेल्टर बेल्ट एंड विंड ब्रेक्स। फर्स्टली ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ द शेल्टर बेल्ट। फर्स्ट वन, टू डिफ्लेक्ट द एयर करंट्स, मीन्स इट ऑल्सो रिड्यूसेस द स्पीड ऑफ विंड एंड विंड प्रेशर एंड हेल्प्स इन प्रोवाइड द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ प्रोटेक्टेड एरिया। देन सेकेंड पॉइंट, टू रिड्यूस द वेलोसिटी ऑफ विंड्स। देन थर्ड वन, to provide general protection to the leeward areas against the effect of wind erosion, means it also provides the protection to the protected area like the orchard or the farmer's house, then or the cultivated forest. Then last point, to protect the leeward areas from desiccating effect of hot winds, it also protect the protected area from the effect of hot winds. These are the objects of the shelter belt. Then नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ शेल्टर बेल्ट्स। फर्स्ट वन, शेप एंड कंपोजिशन। शेल्टर बेल्ट्स हैव ए स्पाइरकल एंड ट्रायंगुलर शेप बाय रेजिंग टॉल ट्रीज इन द सेंटर। मोस्ट ऑफ द शेल्टर बेल्ट हैव ए ट्रायंगुलर शेप बिकॉज ड्यू टू द प्लांटिंग ऑफ टॉल ट्रीज एट द सेंटर। देन सेकेंड पॉइंट, डेंसिटी एंड विड्थ। शेल्टर बेल्ट्स अप टू द 50 मीटर विड्थ आर कंसिडर आइडियल अंडर द इंडियन कंडीशंस। Then orientation depends upon the direction and velocity of winds. Then last point, length. The minimum length of shelter belt should be about 25 times its height, or it also provide the protection up to 25 times of its height. Then next point, windbreak. Windbreaks are the strip of trees or the shrubs planted to protect fields, homes, channels or other areas from wind and blowing soil or sand. It is known as windbreaks. Then purpose of raising windbreaks. First one, to protect the field crops, livestock from the cold and hot winds. Then second one, to protect soil erosion. For example, eucalyptus and tamarinds, these windbreaks have the taproot system or the deep root system. It also provides the protection for the soil erosion. Then third point, to reduce evaporation from the farmlands, because most of the windbreaks provides shade to the soil surface, or it also helps in to reduce the evaporation from the farmlands. Then fourth one, to improve the microclimate. Most of the windbreaks provides the microclimate to the most of the microorganisms or the plants. Then fifth point, for fencing and boundary demarcation, most of the windbreaks like karonda or shrubs, it also act as like a fencing and it protects the planted land from the grazing animals. Then sixth one, for productive role, fuel and fodder purpose, it also provides the wood for the fuel purpose and grasses for the milch animals. Then main features of the windbreaks. First one, permeability. The main purpose of raising windbreaks is to filter and break up the force of wind. Then second one, permeable windbreaks, which allow some wind to pass through, are the most suitable. Then species such as eucalyptus, then casuaria, will form dense mound break, but most native species are more permeable. Then second point, orientation. Orientation means raising of the windbreaks at right angles to the direction of wind. Then second one, planting of the windbreaks in north-south direction. Then thank you all of you.